Hello everybody and welcome to Usitility. Today we are on the way to see how to run Shadow Fight 3 on your PC. Now you are displaying it on screen. We will be able to easily download and install Shadow Fight 3 so that we can play your game on our Windows computer with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to start we have to launch our favorite web browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, because there's a link in the video description and the first main comment. Once clicking on this link, we get to the website of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we will use to play Shadow Fight 3 on PC. It is now obvious that we access some advantages of using this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Now we are ready to start downloading the Shadow Fight 3 by clicking on this button Download Shadow Fight 3 on PC that you can visualize here in green. We then click on this button. And the download step takes no time at all. Here it is. Here is located the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to run the installer, so we need to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installer better. The installer is very simple. It is made up of two possibilities: install and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path genuinely does. We basically simply click on it. And we realize that we display here the path where in fact the emulator can be installed. If we would like to change for better this directory, we have got to click on the browse option, and therefore we choose another directory and install the emulator precisely where we wish. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. Then, I click on back. And I just click install. Now, prior to starting setting up the emulator, will also be possible that it will present us one or two computer software packages to install on the computer. As I do not want any of these software program, I only press several times on the reject button. Now, there it is. The setup commences and it will progress with the download of those MB that are shown on the computer screen. As you download it, it may be a little more or less MB. The download rate can be faster or slower, depending on your type of access to the web and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Right away they are going really fast. The download is finished, then instantly it proceeds with the setup phase. The installation requires more or less time based on the power of your machine. The more robust it is, the shorter the setup time and or vice versa. If we put together the download and software setup phase, it usually takes quite a long time, so show patience. It is now finished on my side. Now, the emulator happens to be started automatically. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will move forward to the right, and when it actually reaches the ending, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. In fact, the emulator has been started. Here it is for the very first time. And LD Store is instantly started, which is a sort of Google Play. This isn't the optimal solution to install the video game, and I really don't propose it, because from time to time the LD Store sets up an out-of-date version of the Android game. I am about to demonstrate the way to install the Android game by utilizing the Google Play. I recommend you to do it this way. The first thing we need to begin doing is to go to the computer's desktop by clicking on this icon that I'm pointing out in green color. Before we continue, as you will notice, it created two app icons here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player app icon will be the only one we are concerned about. Every time we want to run Shadow Fight 3 on our laptop or computer, we twice mouse click on this software icon and run the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything like this. Of course, it is a software icon that we will certainly never use. Let's conduct the next phase, which is a must-have, and that is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. To do this we will browse there to System Apps, we click. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is started. In this case we have to log on. Now once we're here, we must absolutely do the next phase which is imperative. So we mouse click on Sign In. Now it shows Checking Info. It might sometimes get stopped at Checking Info, and it doesn't continue. If so, you may attempt to log in after a number of hours and it will most likely be sorted out. Now we can type our email and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For example, you make use of the exact same email you are using at the moment in your own YouTube account. Thus, I will enter my information and I will go back after I have accomplished it. That's it. Info typed. Here is Google welcoming us and presenting us the terms of service. We must agree to them all by clicking, I agree. Next, it makes possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked and it'll generate a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it. You can utilize that option if you want. We just click on accept. The Google Play is started by default and automatically. In case that the Google Play is not started by default and you don't know how to start it manually, I display how to do this. The first thing is to go to the emulator desktop by pressing this software icon designated in green color. Now we head to the system apps folder. And we click on the Play Store icon. Okay, we are right inside Google Play. What we intend to do will be browse here to search for apps and games. And we are going to research Shadow Fight 3. There we have got it. We will select the first result. Here we come with the Android game. So let's mouse click here on the install option that I'm just displaying now in green color. And it will launch the software setup. At this moment it is going to download and install the Android game. It usually takes quite some time or it could also be very quick. It all will depend on the connection to the web. It's by then finished installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking the following button I'm highlighting in green, so that you can use Shadow Fight 3 for the first time. We are currently on the emulator desktop, and we're on the way to simply click on that fresh Shadow Fight 3 icon that was created. The game app is started for the very first time. Here we have it. I could mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the sound level of the emulator. This is here. We have got the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we do not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of the emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This is actually the very first one. We click on that icon that I am basically mentioning in green color. And the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. If we need to launch the game using all the screen, we click this particular software icon. And we might without a doubt be enjoying the gameplay in full screen setting. To stop the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we'd just be in standard screen mode. Now I am on the way to clarify you the keyboard mapping and that is quite cool. This strategy we will be ready to make use of the game more easily. The first point is to press this keyboard icon. It's now time to complete the necessary setups. I will keep the normal configuration, though if you want to improve that, you can do it with no problem. I take this time to say that sometimes, when launching the game a black screen occurs. If that is like that and you see the black display and this emulator does not start, I propose a viable alternative. We would click here, to the cogwheel. In the emulator preferences, in the advanced selection we have a handful of resolutions. That is the image resolution that we have now selected automatically, therefore we should select any of these other resolutions, for instance that one here. We select it and then click on save. It will probably ask us to restart your emulator and as soon as rebooted, most probably the emulator will start up and this black screen will vanish. As you can see, the emulator is fully in our own language. Sometimes it occurs that the emulator is started in the erroneous language, as an example, in Japanese. And to place it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. And there throughout other configuration settings, we click on the language drop down. We may go with the language we like, Italian, Chinese, and so forth. When the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator would reboot, and also the game application, the next time we run it, would of course be in the specified language. Now, you can find another point that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will receive a message from Google indicating that a completely new device has been connected with our own Google account. It will ask us if we are the individuals who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we must not worry, considering the fact that emulator is acting as in Google Android device. And to determine which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And we browse here to the model selection. And here we realize that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for my tutorial. I hope that you liked it, particularly that everyone found it informative. If so, bring it a nice like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, issues or ideas, leave them in the comment field below. You could even comment things on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams from time to time. You get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of those online videos that happens to be appearing on the suggestion of videos to watch, and let's have fun again in the upcoming training videos. Bye.